So we have read from the chapter, that is the fun they had, up to the part where we see that the girl whose name is Margie, she met Tommy and she came to know about real books. So she starts writing a diary entry and she mentions about it, that how Tommy found a real book. She was actually surprised to know about this thing. She has also learned from her grandfather that how her grandfather's grandfathers, they used to have real books, as the words were printed on pages. The pages used to be yellow, crinkly when the book used to become old, and to Margie, these things were quite funny. She calls it awfully funny, because the printed words on the books, they used to be stood still instead of moving as they were supposed to be. Because in Margie's time, they had computers, they had machines, and they had e-books. So the books used to, the letters, the words used to move on the computer screen. So it was quite little surprising fact for Margie that how the printed books, the words on the printed books used to stood still instead of moving. And moreover, when they turned back the pages, they could find the same words on those pages, which was not so in the machine, the computer screen that they had. And apart from that, what Tommy had shared with Margie, that he found the book to be a waste. He calls it a waste because when you are done with the book, you just don't need that book. That book becomes useless to you and you just throw it away. And he compares his television screen, the e-books on the television screen with the real book, that how his television screen had millions and millions of books and he would never throw those books away. He would never delete those books from his computer screen, as he could easily keep them for longer periods of time. Margie is of same opinion as well, and she supports Tommy, saying that same with mine. And she becomes curious to know more about the real book. And she questions Tommy that where he found the book. And Tommy shared that how he found the book in the attic. But Margie, she becomes a little scornful when she came to know that how the book was about school. Because Margie, she did not like her own school. And that's why she becomes a little angry that what is there to talk about school. So we have read up to this part and now we will start from here. That is the paragraph number 3. I'll just read it again. Margie always hated school, but now she hated it more than ever. The mechanical teacher had been giving her test after test in geography, and she had been doing worse and worse until her mother had shaken her head sorrowfully and sent for the county inspector. So here we come to know that why Margie, she hated her school. She hated because she was not performing well in the geography subject. The mechanical teacher, now here we come to know that how she was taught by a machine. She never used to go to a building named school, and she was taught by this machine, and she was performing really bad in the subject geography. Her performance was actually declining day by day, and the mother became worried. Thus, उन्होंने अपना जो सिर है वो एक डेस्परेट सिचुएशन में हिलाया, बिकॉज शी न्यू दैट हर डॉटर वाज नॉट सो बैड इन स्टडीज, एंड शी शुक हर हेड सॉरोफुली एंड शी सेंट फॉर द काउंटी इंस्पेक्टर. प्लीज अंडरलाइन दिस वर्ड सेंट फॉर. सेंट फॉर का मतलब होता है टू कॉल. सेंट फॉर, इसका जो प्रेजेंट फॉर्म है वो है सेंड फॉर. इसका क्या मतलब होता है? किसी को बुलावा भेजना, टू कॉल समवन. So, यहाँ पर सेंट का मतलब नहीं किसी को कुछ भेज देना, यहाँ पर है बुलावा भेजना, टू कॉल समवन. सो हु वाज कॉल्ड बाय द मदर? द काउंटी इंस्पेक्टर. और ये काउंटी इंस्पेक्टर्स कौन होते हैं? दे आर द इंचार्जेस, given a certain division, certain area to look after all the mechanical teachers provided to the houses of that area. So when Marji's mother, she found that there was some problem with the teacher as well, she called the county inspector. He was a round little man with a red face. So see, the description of county inspector is given. Round little man means his height was short and he was quite a fat man, and that's why his appearance was round like a football. So he was a round little man and he had a red face and a whole box of tools with dials and wires. And he was carrying with himself, what he was carrying? Box of tools, so that he could repair the machine, that is the mechanical teacher. So when he came to their house, he smiled at Marji and gave her an apple. Then took the teacher apart. Took the teacher apart means he dismantled the teacher. Usne pura machine jo tha wo khol diya. The mechanical teacher tha. It was a machine. So he dismantled it to find the problem. And before that, smiling at Marji, he gave her an apple to eat. Marji had hoped he would not know how to put it together again. Marji, she actually hated her teacher. And that's why she just thought that might be the teacher, this county inspector, he would not know how to reassemble the teacher. Put it together means us machine ko dubara se pack karke tayar kar dena. So assemble it, reassemble it, because he had dismantled it. Unhone puri machine khol kar rakh di thi. So Marji ne socha ki kaash is county inspector ko ye machine theek karni na aaye and he would not be able to put it together again. But jaisa Marji ne socha tha waisa to bilkul bhi nahi hua. But he knew how, all right. So us county inspector ko pata tha ki kaise machine ko assemble karna hai. And after an hour or so, there it was again. So what is it here? The mechanical teacher. Kindly underline it and write it there. Mechanical teacher was ready again. The large and black and ugly, with a big screen on which all the lessons were shown and the questions were asked. So see, this is the description of the mechanical teacher given. So you must underline these. These are important information which you will be needing later while writing your answers. So what is described about the mechanical teacher? That it was a large, black and ugly screen, and all the lessons were displayed on the screen. The questions were asked on the screen. But that wasn't so bad. Ye nahi tha ki mechanical teacher bahut bura tha. Theek hai, there was a screen and questions were asked. That was not actually bothering Marji. The part that Marji hated, what was that? She hated most was the slot where she had to put homework and test papers. Slot kya hai? A given space, time or position. Now jaise aapke dekho jo laptop hota hai, wahan par pen drives lagane ke liye slots bane hote hain. Extensions, wires lagane ke liye slots bane hote hain. So this way, the mechanical teacher had a slot where Marji, she had to put her homework and the test papers. And this part she hated the most. She always had to write them out in a punch code. Now punch code jo hota hai, kind of, it's a computer language, right? So computing language hai punch code, jisme holes bane hote hai, and through punching it, you actually write your answer in a coded form. So it is a computing language used to write answers on in the machine. So she had to write all the answers in a punch code. They made her learn when she was 6 years old. So when she had learned how to write in punch code when she was 6 years old, and the mechanical teacher calculated the marks in no time. Ab jaise dekho aapke paas jo OMR sheets aati hain, if you just insert the OMR sheets in the computer, you get your marks at the time immediately. So this way, the mechanical teacher was an expert teacher who would calculate the marks in no time. Immediately, the moment she would put her answers through the slot there with the help of the punch code language, the mechanical teacher used to tell their marks immediately. और मार्जी को ये बिल्कुल पसंद नहीं आता था. The inspector had smiled after he was finished and patted Margie's head. He said to her mother, "It's not the little girl's fault, Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quick." So the inspector smiled as he was done with his work and he patted Margie's head. Pat karna means jab aap pyar se kisi ko thapki karte ho. So he just patted Margie's head and he told Margie's mother. What did he tell her? That it was not Margie's fault. Margie ki koi bhi fault nahi thi that she was performing badly in geography. And Mrs. Jones is Margie's mother's name. She is Mrs. Jones. I think the geography sector was geared a little too quick. Geared means adjusted to a particular standard or level. Now, ye jo machines hoti hain, right? In machines ko different class or child ke level ke according set kar diya gaya tha so that the children can learn according to their age and class. And Margie's mechanical teacher was adjusted according to the level of a child who was more than 11 years old because Margie was just 11. So it was geared a little too quick. Or जो टीचर एडजस्ट हो गया था वो बड़े बच्चे के स्टडी लेवल के अकॉर्डिंग एडजस्ट हो गया था. तो जो भी कुछ वो मैकेनिकल टीचर टीच कर रहा था वो मार्जी के लेवल का नहीं था और इसी वजह से मार्जी को लेक्चर समझ नहीं आता था एंड शी वाज परफॉर्मिंग पुअरली इन द सब्जेक्ट. सो दोज थिंग्स हैपन सम टाइम. आफ्टर ऑल मशीनरी है, मशीनरी कभी भी गड़बड़ कर सकती है ना. तो ये चीजें जो डिफेक्ट होती है मशीनरी में कभी भी हो सकती है, किसी के भी साथ हो सकती है. सो द काउंटी इंस्पेक्टर ही टोल्ड मिसेस जोन्स दैट दोज थिंग्स हैपन सम टाइम्स. आई हैव स्लोड इट अप टू एन एवरेज 10-year लेवल. इसके साथ साथ काउंटी इंस्पेक्टर ने क्या कहा, दैट आई हैव एडजस्टेड इट टू अ लेवल ऑफ अ 10-year-old चाइल्ड. मैंने जो कंप्यूटर टीचर है उसके टीचिंग को स्लो डाउन कर दिया है, उसके लेवल को 10 साल के बच्चे के लेवल के अकॉर्डिंग एडजस्ट कर दिया है. एक्चुअली द ओवरऑल पैटर्न ऑफ हर प्रोग्रेस इज क्वाइट सैटिस्फैक्ट्री. एंड ही एडेड टू दिस इंफॉर्मेशन दैट Margie's performance was still quite satisfactory. She was not at all performing badly. अब देखिए, Margie एक senior level के student का जो study था वो पढ़ रही थी, but still she was doing well. And this was told by the county inspector that after all her performance was not at all bad. She was quite giving a satisfactory performance. And he patted Margie's head again. But see Margie's reaction. Margie was disappointed. Margie ये देखकर बिल्कुल खुश नहीं हुई. She had been hoping they would take the teacher away altogether. और वो क्या उम्मीद कर रही थी? That this county inspector would not know how to repair the teacher and then he would take the teacher away. They had once taken Tommy's teacher away for nearly a month because the history sector had blanked out completely. Blanked out completely means यहाँ पर सब कुछ इरेज हो गया था मैकेनिकल टीचर के ड्राइव्स में से, सेक्टर में से. सो इट गॉट प्लेन विदाउट एनी राइटिंग. दैट मीन्स एवरीथिंग वॉज इरेज फ्रॉम द मेमरी ऑफ टॉमीज मैकेनिकल टीचर. सो दैट्स वाई द टीचर वॉज टेकन अवे फॉर नियरली अ मंथ. तो टॉमी की टीचर जो थी वो घर पे थी ही नहीं और इस वजह से टॉमी वाज रिलैक्स फॉर नियरली अ मंथ. मार्जी भी कुछ ऐसा ही चाहती थी. शी वाज आल्सो होपिंग दैट द काउंटी इंस्पेक्टर वुड टेक द टीचर अवे, बट ऐसा नहीं हुआ. द टीचर वाज स्टैंडिंग देयर अगेन बिकॉज काउंटी इंस्पेक्टर हैड ऑलरेडी रिपेयर्ड इट. सो शी सेड टू टॉमी, Why would anyone write about school? Now we have come back to the present situation where she is writing about the things in the diary. उसने टॉमी से क्या कहा था? Why would anyone write about school? कि स्कूल के बारे में लिखने का ऐसा क्या है? Now just compare the situation. I would here take a pause from the chapter. थिंक अबाउट द टाइम व्हेन यू यूज्ड टू कम टू स्कूल. अभी आप भी अपने घर से पढ़ रहे हो, देखो आपको बोरिंग लगता है ना, आप टीचर का चेहरा नहीं देख पा रहे हो, आपके सामने एक स्क्रीन है. क्या आपको वाकई मजा आ रहा है पढ़ने में? आर यू एंजॉयिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ वर्चुअल टीचिंग? सो सी द कंडीशन ऑफ मार्जी एज वेल. शी यूज्ड टू स्टडी इन हर होम एंड अ रूम वॉज गिवन टू देयर. देयर वॉज द टीचर, मैकेनिकल टीचर, हु वुड टीच मार्जी देयर. And she completely hated the mechanical teacher. She never enjoyed her school. So that's why she said to Tommy, why would anyone write about school? What is there to write about school? Tommy looked at her with very superior eyes. Now Tommy, he was 13 years old. Tommy jo tha wo umr mein bada tha Marji se. और स्टैंडर्ड जो था उसका क्लास का वो भी मार्जी से एक लेवल अप था. एंड ही हैड मोर इंफॉर्मेशन एंड नॉलेज देन मार्जी. सो उसने एक सुपीरियर आईज से उसको देखा, जैसे उसे बहुत कुछ पता है. एंड इसलिए उसने क्या कहा मार्जी से, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट आर काइंड ऑफ स्कूल. बिकॉज टॉमी हैड सम मोर इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट द स्कूल ऑफ द ओल्डन डेज. सो ही सेड टू मार्जी, बिकॉज इट इज नॉट आर काइंड ऑफ स्कूल स्टूपिड. This is the old kind of school that they had hundreds and hundred years ago. He said loftily. Loftily means in a superior way. बड़े शान से, गर्व से, superior feeling रखते हुए उसने मार्जी से क्या कहा कि बेवकूफ, ये हमारे तरह का स्कूल नहीं है. ये बहुत सालों पहले, hundreds and hundred years of ago का जो स्कूल है उसके बारे में है. And he added loftily, pronouncing the word carefully, centuries ago. तो जब ये वर्ड वो प्रोनाउंस करता है, वो बहुत ध्यान से उस पर स्ट्रेस देते हुए कहता है, centuries ago. ये बहुत साल पहले की बात है. Margie was hurt. Well, I don't know what kind of school they had all that time ago. She read the book over his shoulder for a while and then said, anyway, they had a teacher. ओवर हिज शोल्डर मतलब जब आप किसी के शोल्डर से मतलब झांक कर देखने की कोशिश करते हो और ढूंढने की कोशिश करते हो कि सामने वाले के पास क्या है क्या नहीं है. सो द सेम वे शी जस्ट लुक्ड ओवर हिज शोल्डर टू द बुक एंड शी सेड, एनीवे तो क्या हुआ, दे ऑल्सो हैड अ टीचर. उनके भी तो टीचर होते थे. श्योर दे हैड अ टीचर, बट इट वॉजंट अ रेगुलर टीचर. It was a man. Now, what kind of teachers Margie and Tommy have? They have mechanical teacher. It is a machine. So, for them, who is regular teacher? The machine is the regular teacher, right? So, आज के लिए आप लोगों के लिए regular teacher कौन है? हम जो humans हैं. और अगर आपके सामने एक robot आ जाए, तो वो एक regular teacher नहीं होगा आपके लिए, क्योंकि आज के जमाने का जो कम हम देख रहे हैं, वो humans teach करते हैं. So, इस तरह से who were the regular teachers for Margie and Tommy? The mechanical teacher. And that's why Tommy said that sure they had a teacher, उनको भी teachers पढ़ाते थे, but it wasn't a regular one. So he's comparing the teachers of olden days with today's mechanical teacher. That means the teacher of Tommy's age. And he said it was a man, उनको इंसान पढ़ाते थे. A man? How could a man be a teacher? Margie is surprised now more. वो और ज़्यादा astonished हो जाती है कि एक इंसान कैसे एक teacher हो सकता है. Tommy said, well, he just told the boys and girls things and gave them homework and asked them questions. A man isn't smart enough, said Margie. Sure he is. My father knows as much as my teacher, Tommy कहता है. So Tommy क्या information share करता है Margie के साथ? कि जो मैन होते थे टीचर, दे यूज्ड टू आल्सो शेयर द इंफॉर्मेशन जस्ट द वे आर मैकेनिकल टीचर्स. दे टोल्ड द बॉयज एंड गर्ल्स द थिंग्स, दे गेव देम होमवर्क, दे आस्क्ड देम द क्वेश्चन. बट मार्जी क्या कहती है कि नहीं, पर मैन जो है वो कंप्यूटर से ज्यादा स्मार्ट नहीं हो सकता है. तो टॉमी क्या कहता है, श्योर ही इज, माय फादर नोज एज मच एज माय टीचर. टॉमी क्या कहता है कि मेरे पिता को भी उतनी ही नॉलेज है जितनी मेरे मैकेनिकल टीचर को है. He knows almost as much. I betcha. इट्स एन इनफॉर्मल वे ऑफ सेइंग आई बेट यू, हम कहते हैं ना आई बेट यू, मैं श्योरली कह सकता हूँ, आई एम श्योर दैट, ऐसा हो नहीं सकता. सो ही सॉरी ऐसा हो सकता है, ही नोज ऑलमोस्ट एज मच, आई बेट यू. मार्जी वाज़न्ट प्रिपेयर्ड टू डिस्प्यूट दैट. टू डिस्प्यूट मीन्स टू डिसएग्री विद दैट. ठीक है, सो इस वक्त वो टॉमी के साथ झगड़ने के मूड में तो बिल्कुल भी नहीं थी, वो डिसएग्री नहीं करना चाहती थी, और इस वजह से शी सेड आई वुडंट वांट अ स्ट्रेंज मैन इन माय हाउस टू टीच मी. और वो बात बदलते हुए कहती है कि जो भी हो मैं अपने घर पे एक स्ट्रेंज इंसान को नहीं देखना चाहूंगी हु वुड कम टू माय हाउस एंड टीच मी. टॉमी स्क्रीम्ड विद लाफ्टर. You don't know much, Margie. The teachers didn't live in the house. They had a special building and all the kids went there. Aur is par Tommy kya share karta hai information? So he screamed with laughter. Scream karna means cried loudly, laughingly. Wo haste hue Margie ko kehta hai, you don't know too much, Margie. The teachers, they never lived in the house. They never came to the house of the children. They had a special building and all the kids went there. So, वो बताता है कि जो उस पुराने जमाने में there used to be a building जहाँ पर बच्चे जाया करते थे and they used to go and learn things and all the kids learned the same thing. Margie पूछती है, she was really curious to know about the school of the olden days. और वो पूछती है तो क्या सारे बच्चे एक ही चीज पढ़ते थे? Sure, if they were the same age. और टॉमी कहता है, of course, अगर वो सब हम उम्र थे, एक ही एज के थे, तो वो एक ही चीज पढ़ा करते थे. But my mother says a teacher has to be adjusted to fit the mind of each boy and girl it teaches, and that each kid has to be taught differently. तो मार्जी अपनी मदर की ओपिनियन बताती है कि कैसे एक टीचर को एक बच्चे के लेवल के अकॉर्डिंग एडजस्ट होना पड़ता है. Fit according to the mind of each child and teach accordingly. So the teacher, he needs to teach each child differently. Har bacche ke liye alag method hona chahiye. Just the same, they didn't do it that way then. If you don't like it, you don't have to read the book. Now, before I explain this part, students, I would like to stop here. We will continue from here tomorrow. Okay, so let us stop here for today. Thank you all for listening.